BAM! Mr. Taru, in this video I want to do two things. First of all, thank you. I can't believe we're getting close to 100,000 subscribers. It's something I never would have thought would have happened when I started this YouTube channel just over 4 years ago. Thank you for sharing this with your friends, your teachers, putting it out on Facebook and Twitter and all the other social media outlets. It really means a lot. Liking, subscribing, sharing, supporting the advertising. That's what keeps, free YouTube channels like mine alive, besides the fact that I just love teaching and so do many other people out there. You might find some educational channels on the right column or the right margin of my YouTube page that I feel very strongly about. And there's many other good ones, of course, as well. The second thing I want to do is, besides just saying a huge thank you for all of your support, is to actually ask for some help. And I hate asking for help, but over the last 4.5 years, I've produced 565 or more videos. I've covered topics that involve all of the subjects that I've taught live in my classroom, and now I'm extending that into Calculus 2 and such, beyond, just because I'm enjoying this process with YouTube so much. But I can't continue to make new math lessons at a rate that I would like if I don't get some help with closed captioning. YouTube has a feature now that there's a community involvement, or that you guys out there can help me closed caption videos as a big community. And that's what I'm going to ask for. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you could contribute some closed captioning, an entire video or just in small pieces, so that as a collective group, we can open my videos up to, hearing impaired students that speak foreign languages where English is a second language. You can use Google Translate to take English subtitles. And, I know it's not perfect, but translate it to other languages. Or maybe you're in a foreign country and you speak, German or French or something like that, a language that I don't speak. And you can, give me subtitles in your language. Now, you can just jump ahead to the instructions on how to do that if you like, but basically here's the deal. If you're a regular subscriber, you're going to... You probably have noticed that in the last year or so, my new lessons have been coming very, very slowly, over months, a month or a month and a half before another one is produced, if that might even be longer than that. That's because I was getting a lot of requests to closed caption my videos. Now, the reason why they're not closed caption is because, well, we've all seen auto closed captions from YouTube. They're not very good. And I even tried with my lessons now cover all the topics I cover in my class as well as sharing with you all on YouTube. So as I extend my lessons into calculus, I'm relearning and reviewing calculus skills that I haven't seen for 20 years. It felt really good to teach calculus for the first time live in my school about 3 years ago, to open up this calculus book I hadn't looked at in years, watch someone else's lessons, read the book, and then do all that homework and rehone, relearn, dust off my old skills I learned to get my math degree or my math education degree. And I want to now extend that into Calculus 2 and Calculus 3. But over the last 12 months, I've typed about 160 closed captions, and a wonderful lady in India, student and now friend of mine, Jigyasa, she closed captioned about 17 or 18 videos. And a couple of people in the US had committed to listening to an entire video like I do, and basically type into a Word document a transcript for an entire video, and then emailed me that Word document, and then I could upload it and do a sort of auto timing feature and get closed captions out there. But at this rate, in a year, that's amounted to a little over 170 or so, or 180, something like that, videos that have been closed captioned. Well, I have a 567 videos. I would take like another 3 years. I could type for 3 years straight, besides, of course, actually teaching full-time, which pays the bills, before I could post a brand new math lesson. And, I am a math teacher. I want to help. I'm glad that I've opened up 170 or 80 of my videos so far to, hearing impaired and such people that can also benefit from my classes. But, I need some help. I can't do it all. And so let me show you how to help me. And I'm begging, I'm pleading, please, just even if you can do 10, 20 seconds of a lesson as a collective group, we can open up all of my math lessons so that everyone can learn from them, not just those that speak English, you know, or that can hear. So here's how we're going to help.
Okay, so here we are. It's the homepage of my channel. You want to help out. You want to do some closed captions. Where do you go? You go to the video tab where all the videos are, right? And when you go to videos, you can go from newest to oldest, or you can click this tab and go from most popular to least popular. But that is actually how I closed caption my videos. I went from my most viewed lessons and worked my way backwards. So pretty much everything here, except, okay, a little bit there, you'll find are already closed captioned. Well, if you want to start there and go and keep working your way backwards or whatever, if you find a video that interests you that has not been closed captioned yet, like my most recent video, Definite Integration by Trigonometric Substitution, you can click on this video that does not have a CC in the lower right-hand corner, and once it starts playing, unless there's some kind of glitch or something, you will see if you hit, let me pause this quick, you can click on the settings tab and see that CCs are turned off. Well, that's because I don't have any closed captions. Click on that tab and here is the ability, I've turned this on for community contributions for closed captions. Click add subtitles. This wonderful little window pops open. Select language, which I speak English and my videos are in English. And you can, pretty sure you can select any video. Oh, we see here that this video does have some community input already for closed captioning. Actually, I did these as I was trying to figure out how to do this process from your end. And we can pick up now that you can see if someone else contributes some subtitles, they're going to be there for someone else to then come in and add a few more. And then when all of these are done, the closed captions get opened up for community review, or I can review them once the entire video is done. Again, math talk, doing talk to text does not work well. That's why I've had to type all these. And so I'm scrolling through here. I always want to drag those to the left and kind of get all this to run as a smooth, continuous stream of closed captions. And here we go. So if I hit play.
Trigonometric substitution, we're going to remove all references of x and put in references of theta.
Oh, okay. So references of theta, that's where the closed captions have stopped. Now, I'm going to, by the way, you have keyboard shortcuts. You can shift left to go back 5 seconds, shift right to go forward. Shift space is what I use the most, is to pause the video so you can type. You can add a new line and such. I never really pay attention to those. I just always need to pause the video because I'm not a really quick typist. And by the way, you can hit this settings tab and watch the video at normal 1/2 or 1/4 speed. When I typed an entire transcript into a Word document, I would listen to my video at 1/4 speed because that's about how fast I can type, and I sound very interesting at that rate of speed. But this is going to, you can see timestamps occurring as you enter the closed captions, so this would not be an area where you do an entire transcript. So we're going to just listen to normal speed. Back this up a little bit. I'm just clicking and dragging this. And here we go. Play.
And put in references of theta. Well, I can't write a definite integral with
Okay, I can't write a definite integral with references. So I'm going to come up here to type subtitle here and then press enter. So I think I said I can't write a definite integral with references. So let me click and drag this back just to listen.
References of theta. Well, I can't write a definite integral with references of theta with the same lower and upper limit of...
Now, do you see what happened there? As soon as I started typing, the video paused, and that's because this box is selected, and you want to do this until there's two complete lines of text, and then once you're done, you're going to hit enter. But just to make sure I said the right thing, or type the correct thing.
Well, I can't write a definite integral with references of theta with the same lower and upper limit of 0 and 4.
So I've got about two complete lines of text. I can hit enter. And that just put that down at the bottom of the list of current closed captions. And that's pretty much it. You can back, you can click and drag this backwards and forwards. It play again.
0 and 4 because those are in terms of X.
Now I'm going to hit shift space to keep going.
So if you like, you can, and it's a,
see, I'm not a great typist. Back, hit play.
Can, and it's just a different, it's preference, whatever you prefer.
What was that second, I just said?
So if you like, you can, and it's, it's just a different, it's preference, whatever you prefer.
And then enter. So you can see this process, you know, is lengthy. Now, as you get used to this, certainly I can close caption a video much, much faster than I used to when I got started. But this is how you can help me. And now if this is all you want to do, you can hit submit for review down here. Ultimately, when this entire video is closed captioned, it will be opened up to review to, again, you all, the community, to make sure that there's, you know, nothing inappropriate is correct. And then once enough people approve it, it will be published. Or I can do that as well once the entire video is done. So please, if you would be willing to pay me back a little bit, and all your other fellow free educators for that matter, and allow us to continue to make our lessons, allow me to continue to make my math lessons, and help you extend, you know, into Calculus 2 or any other anything else for that matter, and help me close caption, it would be greatly, greatly appreciated. So I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do some closed captions. Please! Before I go, I just noticed one last thing. After you hit submit for review, this window pops open and says, are these done or not? No, let others keep working on them. Yes, they're ready to be reviewed. So I guess if you got all the way to the end of the video, note, these subtitles need to be reviewed by others before they are published. You won't see them right away. So, of course, we're going to hit no, let others keep working on them because, well, they're not done.